Now, that was a really good win. A lot of respect for Bowling Green coming in. We had a couple good wins. Coach Clawson's guys are good. He played really good D. Mature on offense, you know, and I still thought it'd be a team we could match up with and should be well. We need to play well. So just proudly responded, and not great in all phases, but pretty good across the board and good team wins. Nice to be 2-1, and a great challenge coming in next week from Missouri.
You talked about the, it looked like you got really strong corner play today. Can you just talk about those guys and the job they did? Well, it's, and that's a hard deal because, you know, if we really try to protect those guys mathematically, there's just, you know, can you hold up in the run game? And these guys are, you know, like a lot of teams don't have enough balance, and
so then they get out there on the island, and I thought early they worked us a little bit pretty good, tried some double moves, missed a shot they had early, had a big, had an open shot they missed. Looked like they were trying to pick on Mike a little bit, especially early, but he settled down. But again, for some of the teams that we're going to see it through this conference, we're going to see teams that are going to run the ball strong. We're going to have to put numbers up there, and they're going to be 1-1. That's, you know, in practice, it's, you can be, it's not as stressful out there. You know, all of a sudden you soften up and you got some soft coverage. So I thought Mike and Timmy competed, made some plays, and that's a, it's a developing position. I mean, Mike, you know, he missed his last year with a hernia. Timmy's played safety, so I mean, those guys are kind of learning on the fire, and they're doing good. I mean, it's a good point you're making. But they're going to be challenged and pressed and stressed even more next week with the crowd coming in and what we'll see in the Big Ten play.
Coach, can you talk about the overall defensive effort and just getting off the field on third and fourth down?
It was good. I think we had 10 stops, you know, three and outs, you know, or third down stops here or whatever. They were actually 8 of 20 on third down, 2 of 6 on fourth down. I think another thing was, you know, we were 0 for 3, and they were 0 for 3 in the red zone. And so they worked us down there pretty good. They missed a field goal once. But again, I think it was pretty good. At the end of the game, you know, they were just, you know, what made us aggressive as they would have been early. But, you know, guys, they did bend a little. But we got them on third down, got them third and long, got some pressure on the quarterback a little bit. And sometimes they worked us and converted. But, I mean, it was nice to see the defensive players. I thought our guys did a nice job in practice. Our coaches gave a good plan, and it was nice to come out and play well.
Just do for those guys to rebound like that. I mean, after the game they had last week, to come back and have that good of an outing where you don't give up a touchdown on that side of the ball.
Yeah, I mean, it's good. I mean, because, again, last week, you know, they're the worst defense they ever played in the history of the universe. You know, if you just listen, so now they're going to be the greatest thing ever. Now they're just out there, they're young, they're getting better. You got some freshman linebackers, and, you know, there's not a senior in the defensive line. You got two corners you're talking about that are kind of really, they're really third game. So, I mean, it's just, you know, you're learning on the fire. It was different. But really, what the thing was, last week we never got that team on schedule, ever. And when we did, we got to some of those third and eights. We almost got the stop or the second 20 or the PI call last week. At least today, we had some negative plays that got them a little bit more mathematically. You know, when they got to third and 2, 3, 4, they worked us pretty good today. They hit some of those flat passes, those little rub things they were doing. They worked us pretty good. But, you know, the key of the third down stop was, you know, we did a pretty good job in run defense. They ran for 136 yards, you know, in almost 40 carries, you know, 30-some carries, so 36 there. So, you know, we had 48 for 260, and they had 36 for 130, and it was the D-line and the run support got it third and long. The offensive scoring, it's kind of a team deal. You know, when the offense starts scoring and gets some points, now that changes maybe how they got to attack. So it's kind of like when you play as a team. Today was a good team run, and except for the blunders on the goal line, there was a lot of positive things going. And so that being said, I think the way the offense played really complemented the defense. The way the defense stopped the run, got it third and long, really complemented the defense. So it was a byproduct of the day.
Coach.
And that's why I think it's a good team win. Just it's great for the defense, but it's really is a good team win.
You mentioned Nick Mangieri is a guy who's played pretty well at fall camp. Looked like he had a pretty good day today. What are your thoughts on what you saw from Nick?
Playing hard, and again, I thought a year ago Nick was going to be pretty good as a freshman and didn't play poorly, but I think he's more mature, more confident. Zach Shaw, I thought, had some good pressures coming at the edge. You know, Latham was close and Bobby inside, so it's just, you know, we're still working on it. We're still getting better. We're still getting off blocks, but there's a lot of potential. That crowd's a long way away from being good. It's a young group. It's a good. I just talked about a bunch of guys that are all sophomores and one junior. We're freshmen, so but those guys are getting good, and Nick played hard.
Coach,
talked about this team's inability, I guess, to in the past to overcome adversity. What was different with the missed opportunities inside the five in the first half, the blocked punt? I mean, just what was different about the way they handled it today?
Yeah, we talked a lot about, like we told them at halftime, we're going to do a surprise kick because it was there. And I go, hey, if we don't get it, we're going to stop them this score. It doesn't matter because it's not always going to be perfect. So we talked a lot about trying to play as hard as we could and have some fun and quit worrying about the result. Because last week, I think we started looking at scoreboard. We were pressing and trying and all that. Don't worry about scoring touchdowns. Don't worry about getting stars to score. Don't worry about the season. Don't worry about being a bowl team. What about today and this week? And quit being so selfish. What about the big picture? So we just talked about having some fun and playing hard. You know, and don't matter what happens, have some fun. Is it going to be perfect? No. But we're going to chase perfection. We're never going to get there. We're going to fight it. We're going to scratch it. We're going to claw it. But it's going to mess up a lot, but we're going to keep fighting. And last week, I knew the way they played that they would fight. But I didn't think we came out winning. I think we had a lot of fun. So this week, let's come out winning. Let's have some fun. And you've proved you'll play 60 minutes. Let's put it together and see what happens.
Given the difficulties running the ball, you know, in the goal line situations, but also even out in the field early, did you guys find something as the game wore on to, you know, get some quick hits or some big games?
You know, we tried to do a little bit of a tempo, sometimes just boom or bust. That is a team that mathematically was going to outnumber you and just put numbers up. It was going to be a one-on-one game early. It was going to be a perimeter game early. You had to protect. But we had to run enough. I really liked it halftime when I looked. And we had some good halftime stats, but we had 28 runs and 21 passes instead of 30 and 15 the other way where we throwing it too much. So we were able to have some good mix and good balance, and I think that helped protection, helped us get a rhythm. And I thought both Steven and Tevin both played really, really hard. I did like the goal line runs, but other than that, they were very, very good today.
You talked about the quarterback situation, and was it difficult to integrate Trey into the game, or what were you trying to do there?
Well, again, I don't know if we want to go. The first time we've gotten into a little bit more of a flow of a game, and again, they were a little cat and mouse with us, but our thought is to take advantage of their skill sets. But, you know, we do in practice a lot, but it's the first time a game's happened that way. The first game, you know, the thing got rolling, Trey got nicked, whatever. Last game, it was so short possessions. It's like we played two games, and we haven't really had a true offensive flow of a game. You have one that went real fast and got rolling. It was unusual, and then you have one that was real quick. And the thought was, it's just to kind of integrate them during the deal and take advantage of Trey's athleticism, take advantage of the way Nate's playing, which has been awfully high. And the tough deal is, and like I told you, Nate, to me, it's hard on us because all three of those guys are good players and good kids. You love them all, but there's only one ball. And that's where, again, I thought last week we're worried about the season instead of the process. We're worried about, you know, who's getting the ball, who's starting. So just being a good teammate and having fun and loving each other as a family, let's just keep rolling. And we talked a lot about that Wednesday, Thursday. Just come back to, let's care about each other. And, you know, I didn't win a lot of practice days back. You know, I can't go back and get Saturday back from a week ago. So moving forward, let's have good practice. These games are priceless. Let's just look back and say, hey, why did we come out? So we just, you know, we're trying to take advantage of the guys' feet, and we're just trying to talk, embrace them, be in a group, and having some fun and playing together. Is that it?
Tony Latimer targeted nine times the first couple of games. He had six catches today. Was there more of an effort to get him involved?
You know, I mean, still didn't get a ton. Sometimes it's just, you know, I mean, the one touchdown he threw, I was actually looking at the other side. I thought we were coming the other way because it was mirrored routes. So sometimes it's just, you know, by formation, if we're on the right hash, maybe it goes this way. If we're on the left hash, it's going to Kofi or Stoner. So it's sometimes, you know, we did talk about, I wouldn't say fortunate, but make sure that there was going to be the opportunity. Ted Bozer's been off the guy. I guess today I would see his name here. Maybe only had that one early catch. I don't know if Ted had him or not. So now all of a sudden I get about Ted. That's part of the problem. There's a lot of skill guys. There's only one ball. But when the defense, when we do score points and we do get a team one-dimensional and the defense gets the ball back for us, the offense gets more swings, the ball gets around more, both backs get 100 yards, quarterbacks start playing, it's fun. And so we weren't trying to push Cody, but I know it was a big game for Cody. You know, Cody's father actually played at Bowling Green. His dad passed away, I think, 8 years ago as a young man. Was a very big part of it. So I know personally that it was pretty good for three. That's why we had him as a captain today.
Was there just more for your outside receivers today in general? I mean, obviously, Cody.
Yeah, because they just numbers. It was a one-on-one game. Just their stuff.
the first pitch out, or the quick pitch to Ted went down the sideline, that was a matter of getting outside the box too a little bit quicker.
Well, the first one we fumbled. So it's one for two. It's almost a turnover. It was just a quick speed option.
But that's the same thought, was just get outside.
Yes, get in the perimeter.
Coach, the prior point, it sounds like you're trying to keep the team like very level. You didn't want them to soak or get too down after the Navy game. It sounds like, nor do you want them to be overly ecstatic after this one.
Well, I don't know about that, but we didn't handle coming off the first game as far as coming back against the one I think against a good team from a week ago. And moving forward this week, you know, I thought we had a really good Sunday night. We talked about having the best week we've ever had coming off a loss. Now, if you're a good team, good teams repeat it, so now you have a very good week coming off a win. And again, I think, again, a lot of respect for Bowling Green. A real good team. They're going to win a boatload. They'll be in bowl games. They'll have a great one at their championship. And so, again, it was very proud of our guys to come out and play well. And moving forward, again, we just, it's, we're growing, we're learning, we're figuring out, and we got a lot of figuring to do.
Could you talk a little bit about your offensive line play today, especially Jason Spriggs at left tackle?
Well, we did stay with the run. We did bust a few things in the pressures. We had a couple quarterback hits, hurries, but it was better. It was a better week in practice by those guys. But again, I think those guys, their group, much like the show we're talking about David there, it's so easy to just think we're doing pretty good and you lose your edge. And because, again, it's a young crowd. It's a crowd that can play good when it's on the edge and it's prepared and ready. And today they were. And they'll get a much different challenge against a really athletic Missouri team next week. Thanks for coming.